Halloween in Austria. Instead of serving up candy every year, the people of Austria have a different way of celebrating Halloween. Every year, people leave water, bread, and a lit lamp on their tables just before going to bed. It is believed that doing so on this particular night will welcome back dead souls to the earth. Austrian Catholics use this time to celebrate All Saints Week, between the 30th of October and the 2nd of November. During this time, masses are held and families decorate the graves of their loved ones with lanterns and wreaths. On the final day, a large requiem mass is held to remember those who have passed on.
Halloween in China. In China, a Halloween festival is held every year. During this time, the Chinese put food and water in front of photographs of their departed relatives. There are also bonfires and lanterns that are lit in the hopes of the guiding spirits back to the earth. Those in the Buddhist temples create paper boats called boats of law, which are later burned in the evening. The wandering spirits are considered to be dangerous and as a result may carry out ceremonies to aid them in their journey to the afterlife.
Halloween in England. Instead of carving pumpkins, the English used to carve beetroots. The children then proceed to go from door to door asking for money. In some areas, turnip lanterns were placed in front of homes to keep away spirits who roam the night on Halloween. Another custom was to throw objects such as stones, chestnuts, and vegetables into a large bonfire in hopes of scaring away spirits. The objects were also used as devices for fortune telling. For example, if a pebble was thrown in the fire and was no longer visible the following morning, then it was believed that the person who threw the pebble would not survive another year.
Halloween in France. The French don't celebrate Halloween to honor the departed like other countries do. In fact, they didn't really know about Halloween until a short while ago. The French didn't start celebrating Halloween till the mid-1990s. Much like the American Halloween, people in France get dressed up in costumes and go store to store instead of home to home to get their candy. Halloween is viewed as an American holiday, and for this reason, many French residents do not know what exactly is being celebrated, as it is something that is considered a byproduct of corporate America.
Halloween in Ireland. Most people consider Ireland to be the birthplace of Halloween, and it's really not so different from the well-known American Halloween festivities. Like in the United States, the Irish dress up, go trick-or-treating, and attend parties. All these parties, games, are played to pass the time. Snap Apple is a popular game played by tying an apple to a string, then hanging it onto a tree or a doorframe, where participants then try to take a bite out of it. Treasure hunts are also arranged, as well as card games where face-down cards are hiding either candy or money, and the participants receive whatever is under the card of their choice.
Halloween in Mexico. In Mexico, Halloween is called El Día de Muertos, or Days of the Dead. The event begins the evening of October 31st and ends on November 2nd. The day is spent by graves of loved ones picnicking and celebrating their lives. The dead are believed to return to their homes on this night, so in preparation of this, altars are constructed and decorated with candy, flowers, water, photographs, and portions of the deceased's favorite food and drink. On November 2nd, families that then have picnics by the loved ones' graves and tend their final resting place by cutting weeds, repairing what's necessary, and even painting.
Halloween in Japan. Though they know about Halloween, the Japanese do not celebrate it in the same manner as Americans do. Instead, the Japanese celebrate the Obon festival, also known as Matsuri or Urobon, a festival dedicated to the spirits of their ancestors. Red lanterns are hung around the area for the festivities, and candles are then lit and placed into the lanterns, which are sent to float down rivers and seas. Welcoming fires are lit to guide spirits back to their homes, and then send-off fires are lit after the festivities are over with. For those in the city, small fires are lit and placed in memory of the departed and are left outside overnight.
Halloween in the Philippines. In the Philippines, like most countries, Halloween is more focused on the dead and celebrating their lives than what we are used to. Though the influence of American Halloween is gradually starting to spread in the Philippines, the tradition of Pangangalulua is still being celebrated. People go from house to house and sing songs about the souls trapped in purgatory and in exchange ask for food or money. It is said that during Halloween, loved ones manifest themselves by taking items. These items are supposedly found in the yard the next morning.
Halloween in Scotland. Halloween was first celebrated in Scotland in the 16th century. At first, people will try and predict the future on Halloween, and by the 18th century, most Halloween customs were methods by which young people would search for a spouse. Costumes were common during Scotland's Halloweens as early as the late 19th century. Children would go door to door asking for food and money while guising in costumes. This is very similar to American Halloween traditions, which are more of the norm in Scotland nowadays.
Last and certainly not least is Halloween in the United States of America. American Halloween is by far the most popular and well-known way of celebrating the holiday. Children dress up in costumes and go door-to-door in their neighborhoods trick-or-treating, bringing home bags of candy. Costume parties are held where people play games, eat, and drink. Pumpkins are carved for decorating and lit with a candle. These jack-o'-lanterns have become one of the holiday's most identifiable trademarks. Originally, the term trick-or-treat came from the idea that kindness must be shown to dead ancestors to avoid them playing tricks on you. Now it's more of a courteous way of asking for candy.
We hope you enjoy our spooky Halloween customs from around the world. And remember, stay young and have fun and have a happy and safe Halloween.
Please subscribe by hitting the subscribe button or click on the frog icon on the video. Don't forget to click the bell to get notified of our future videos. And of course, please click on the thumbs up.
And remember, stay young and have fun.